So what kind of off-season do you think you have?
I mean, it's off-season. I feel like that's like the time where you have the most fun. Really relaxed, get chemistry down. You know, we do our dances. I mean, we're going to do our dances anyway. But just having a whole bunch of fun, just building chemistry. There's a lot of new guys on this team, as everybody knows. And so, you know, getting to know these guys, know their background, that's kind of like the biggest thing. And for me, that's kind of what I took into this offseason, trying to get to know the guys because, you know, camp is really tough to, you know, juggle a lot of guys. But I think during that time, that's where you really see the grind. And so this is just really fun to get out here during this time doing voluntary stuff and work out.
How much better do you think this team was or is now than it was at the end of last season?
Yeah, we got a lot of new pieces in here, which I think complements the players we got, especially at quarterback. You know, we have Derek, and we have added some additional pieces that complement him. And I think it's going to be great. I think it's going to be really good. He's really comfortable. Like I've said in many interviews before, it feels like he's been here already. And I'm really excited about it. I mean, guys are, you know, rallying around him. You got the defense. We all building camaraderie. I would say this is probably the most intense practice has been since I've been here, you know, besides my first year. But other than that, like, guys are getting after it. We're having fun. It's just a lot of fun competing with the defense now. So I'm excited to see what we got.
You had a great year last year.
Mm-hmm.
Can you do that again?
I mean, I feel like there's so much more I could give and so much more that I have. I feel like a lot of people harp on, like, the season I've had, but there's so much more that could be done. And I feel like a large part of it is because, you know, we didn't have a postseason. And so, you know, a lot of people want to focus on an individual thing when, you know, you go in the off season and all, everything is like, oh, I did my job. But at the end of the day, you feel so lonely because you're watching other people, you know, in postseason, you know, fulfilling what, you know, everybody wants. And so, yes, I had it was good. But there's so much better that I can do.
Do you feel like you have a chance to be one of the best at your position?
Yeah, I mean, that's why I play. I mean, some other people, they just go out there, go through the motions, but that's never been me. Even when I wasn't the guy, I always felt like I had a lot of confidence in my ability, had a lot of confidence in the people around me, and I'm finally getting my chance to show it. And yeah, I mean, I really feel I can be the best heading out there. Obviously, there's guys like Travis Kelce, George Kittle, TJ. I mean, there's a lot of guys out there who are really, really good. And yeah, I just have to, you know, keep working and doing my thing and helping this team win games, because once the team win games, you know, the individual accolades come together. So, yeah.
So how is Taysom Hill as a teammate? And is he the most unique football player you've
yeah.
ever played with?
Unique, but I feel like he's the most selfless too, because it's like he comes in here and, you know, he's playing quarterback and then he's playing tight end, he plays running back and receiver. I don't think any other guy would be able to, you know, mentally deal with that, but he's done such a great job with it the whole time. You know, it hasn't been the easiest for him, but, you know, this team really prioritizes him, and I think that's the biggest thing about it. He's smart, he's unique. Call him the Swiss Army knife for a reason. He can do everything, but I think he's really taken his role and, you know, expanded on it, and I think that's better for the whole team.
Do you ever think about if you had a bunch of years strung together, how much money you could make? Or is that, I mean, as a player, I
yeah.
mean, there's a small window for
yeah.
financial
yeah.
security. I mean,
yeah.
is that kind of crossed
no
your
doubt.
Mind?
Yes, I mean, we always got to look at, you know, what is obviously clear, but I haven't come from a large part of money growing up, so I mean, $200 of me was just great, and even the money that I'm making now, it's just an add-on to what a dream that I'm living right now, because I mean, I've never would have thought, leaving my rookie year, that I'd be sitting here right now taking interviews about how good of a season I had last year. I wouldn't have thought of that, but. You know, with the grace of God, I think the ability that he's given me, it's just funny. I just think it's so funny.
It's kind of almost an out-of-body experience, right?
Definitely. Because, I mean, sometimes I just sit back and just giggle because it's just like, it's so real to me. But I definitely think that's just the hard work, and he knew all along what he had to give me. And so just had to be patient in that and grind. And I'm glad I have a whole bunch of teammates around me that rallied around me and knew the ability that I had even during practice. And so just showing that in the game just meant so much more.
Did you ever lose faith?
Yeah. I think I lost more faith in myself early on. But I think when you just know, when you just know your plan, and God knows your plan, I think it just made it so much more clear and evident. And so going into it, especially last year and the past 2 years, it's been so fun. And knowing that, you know, it's just always fun to go out there and do what He's put inside your heart.